now all of a sudden, five of those that I've just mentioned have all disappeared.
I think it's poor business by Southampton what they've done this season. Eh?
Probably look at Southampton to finish 13th, 14th, somewhere in that sort of region.
New Saints manager Ronald Koeman says he knew the club was a perfect match for him straight away.
We got our number one choice.
When the dream comes true, you're very happy. So, like I said, I'm very happy to play.
I thought it was an opportunity, you know, too good to miss.
We're going to give him more assists and he's going to score more goals and we're going to give Southampton points, what is most important.
Good football was always recognised down here and hopefully I can be on a good winning Southampton side from now on.
And the clearance is awful, and the shot comes in, and it is 6-0!
Is it down? Then he over, Krabacki killer, what a goal that is!
The side of the pitch is Jakubovic's clearance is average, Wanyama tries to shoot from distance! Oh, we've had another remarkable start to a game!
Amazing goal. It's not that you can watch every weekend.
A bit surprised, and I didn't expect this fantastic season.
We will always have that aspiration to get better and compete with the big boys, and maybe, you know, upset the apple cart a little bit. And maybe, you know, people don't like that happening, but we don't care.
The summer was fantastic. Good weather. We have a house in Portugal on a golf course, and we enjoy it. We enjoy it first 2 weeks with my wife and with some friends, and playing a lot of golf. And the last week we had the whole family together, and that was nice. And
quality time with the family, you know, the extended family as well, the guys that you don't get to see you know, too often during the season. Because of how you know the life of a footballer is, it's every weekend and Christmas and Easter's and all those other bank holidays. So for us, that's the time of the season. That's our Christmas, our Easter's all rolled into one, so it was a good opportunity to spend some quality time with the whole family, and very much enjoyed it.
And also during the summer, you have your telephone on the your mobile on the side, and I spoke a lot to Les Reed.
So I'm kind of here at the helm. Ronald's away because the thing is, you don't want your coach. You want your coach to have a break. You want him to go away, relax, you know, and be ready and fresh to come back for pre-season training, because it's a long, stressful year. So, and we were in it right to the end, and so it's important that he goes away, but it's important that you remain intact.
Of course, it's always football, because to be the manager is different than to be the player. To be the player, you put everything behind yourself and you take holiday, and as a manager you're always a little bit involved in the business, and but it was a relaxing summer.
Because our scouts at the end of the season, guys like Ross and Bill Green, who are Bill is responsible for first team scouts, they're out watching all the international games, all the tournaments and so on. So everyone's remote. So as long as you have a system for keeping in touch. The big thing with Ronald is that you know, the way we work it is he hasn't got to worry about all of the minutiae that goes along with negotiating and getting a deal done. Or what he has to do is be in the loop in terms of approving the selection process and the short list and the target list and who's number one. And I have to keep continually going back to him and saying, this one's more difficult, should we go for that one? So we just have to keep in touch. And I take all the pressure off him in terms of phone calls, negotiations, meetings, travelling around, flying here, flying there, you know, as does Ross.
Just before the closure of the season, before Ronald and the coaching staff went on holiday, Les and I again met with Ronald and the full coaching staff to review where the group was and where we were thinking we were going to be going forward. And it was at that point that we laid out some of the positions, some of the key positions for us, and identified the players that the scouts had been flagging up, where the due diligence had been strong. There would never be anybody presented at that point where there was no information, where there was no scout reports, there was no analysis, there was no video clips, there was no, you know, information behind what the financials may be or the possibilities might be behind the transfer. And it was at that point, just at the end of the season, we decided that Juanmi and Cédric and Maarten Stekelenburg would be targets for us.
Before a player signs for us, it's crucial that we perform a thorough pre-signing medical. So really we're looking, this is a question of risk really, we need to make sure that the club are investing in a player with a good medical and good playing and good physical history. If players have any injuries, that they have been fully investigated and properly managed in the past. Sometimes players will come and we can see that they may not be physically fit at the point, but we're always looking for potential for the club and potential for improving their physical status, improving their movement analysis, and we're really looking for potential.
Okay, you're winning. I got a feel.
During the medical, obviously we do a thorough physical examination, top to toe, really, and look at very fine movement patterns to make sure they've got good quality movement. And we also will do an MRI scans for any issues that we might come across. And Juanmi was really impressive in the medical. He had some great physical attributes, and we're really looking forward to working with him to help him improve over the years.
Largo, soplar largo.
It went very, very smoothly, as we'd hoped, and he's really joined the team. And you can see from him in training, there's great quality there, and he's really fitting in well with the team. So yeah, that went very smoothly. You know, we used all the resources we had to do the medical for him, including scans, and all went very smoothly. We've got an excellent radiologist who will respond to us. We often pax mail or send images electronically to get them reviewed quickly. So, you know, obviously time is of the essence, in these medicals. So we have to respond, and we have to react quickly and respond quickly and get results back to the company quickly, to the club quickly.
Arms across.
Rather than be looking at, players who all of a sudden become available because they've been relegated and being reactive, you know, we followed our policy of tracking players over a long period of time, doing the due diligence, making sure they're right characters and they'll fit in the dressing room. Because having had two good seasons with a strong dressing room and good characters, you have to keep that going. You don't want turmoil, you want people who are going to slot in. And judging by the way Juanmi's come back into pre-season, he's just slotted in like he's been there forever, which is fantastic.
The end of the process, Les and I met Juanmi's representatives in London, and we very, very quickly agreed the deal, to be honest, very, very quickly. And then we met the player about 3 or 4 days later, so we met him here. Everybody was on holiday at that point, so we met and showed him around the place. He was taken aback by the facilities that we have here at Staplewood, so that was really impressive for him. He was really excited about that, and despite the language barrier, you could see he was visibly excited about the prospect to not only joining Southampton, but the opportunity to train in this environment every day was something that was exciting to him. So so we at that point we're meeting face to face, we're beginning to talk about the club, we're beginning to talk a lot more detail the financial part is back. You know, we've finished the, we've agreed the terms, so we're now having a contract wrangle, if you like. So Les and I completed that in London, as I say, fairly smoothly. And then when Juanmi came here, he was, as I say, really excited.
So I'm the player liaison for the first team and the under-21s. When a player first comes in, I sort of greet them, make sure that they've got everything they need in immediate time. The first thing they normally get is a SIM card or a new phone, just so they can communicate with their friends, family, people back home. So when Juanmi signed, I got his number, and we're actually texting through a translation app, which, you know, is probably about 80% correct, but having a lot of Spanish speakers at the club. I mean, Ronald speaks fluent Spanish, as does Sammy Lee, and then you know, we have other members of the team and playing squad that speak fluent Spanish. So helping, you know, I'm doing my best to translate, but you know, we've got a lot of stuff done for him as well, I think. You know, he's got his phones, so he's happy, and we know, I think we found him an apartment as well. So even though it's only been a couple of days since he signed, you know, we're really trying to get them in as quickly as possible, because, you know, it's a new country for him, it's a new language, it's a new experience. So we just want to make sure that he can really relax and unwind without having to worry about, you know, can I speak to this person, or how do I order this, you know, when we have a good support staff here.
As club captain, how important is your role with new players when they first arrive?
I suppose you know, they probably know the answer to that, but how I see it is, I just try to make them feel welcome, try to you know, point them in the right direction around the training ground and around the area, and you know, try to install a bit of what we're about here. You know, we like to look after each other, and we like to be a group that have got each other's interests at heart. So for me, you know, it just starts with a friendly face and, you know, exchange of telephone numbers, and hope that if they need anything or have any questions, or make them feel comfortable enough that, you know, to ask the question if they need anything.
Come on, give him some space. Come on. Okay. Stay away from these.
Juanmi, of course, isn't fluent in English at the moment. How's your Spanish?
Well, I was in Spain for a couple of weeks in the summer, so you know, it's absolutely terrible. But he understood the message. We had a brief chat, and you know, he's fortunate. There's other sort of Spanish speakers in the dressing room, and we have an interpreter here at the club that's in and around the lads. So he gets by, and you know, he's a friendly guy as well. So he understands that you know, what we're trying to achieve, and he realises that. You know, he's going to learn the language as quickly as he can, because he can't rely on too many of us learning Spanish.
Stekelenburg is a world-class goalkeeper. He's played in the World Cup final. He's played in the Premier League. Didn't quite work out for him at the club he was at, but that doesn't make him a bad player. He's played in the Champions League. He's played in European competition. And at the time we needed, you know, this summer, needing to replace Fraser on a temporary basis, we happen to have a world-class goalkeeper available. Now, the bonus is, not only is he known to us, and not only do we know what he's like and so on, he's worked with a manager before. So when you bring all that together, it's a great combination.
Because he's a player that has played, you know, in some big clubs and on big stages, and he's been around a bit. And, you know, he's been involved with high standards, if you like. And he was very, very impressed by what Southampton's got to offer, both in terms of the stadium at St Mary's, the people, the way things are handled in the training campus here at Staplewood. So that was one where somebody of his standing very, very humbly spoke about how impressed he was by the club, and that was that was good as well for the club. We were really pleased with that. It's, you know, when there's some younger players coming, you know, without, you know, talking ourselves up too much, we know that what we've got to offer here is quite an impressive facility, and it's great to see them be excited about it. But somebody like Maarten at the other end of the scale that's been other places and to come and be so impressed was pleasing.
You'll clean your boots out here and I'll put them back in there.
Yeah, I've given them the academy. Traditional.
You can clean your own if you want.
Very, very good professional negotiations with his agent, you know, who I know reasonably well from the past. Obviously knows Ronald, worked with Ronald before. All pieces of the jigsaw fitted together. And so here you're dealing with a player who's at the top, and whose agent has dealt with him moving to big clubs like Monaco and so on. So there's a different expectation, but it's amazing. They walk in here, look at the facilities and go, wow. And you know they're motivated. And it's a different challenge for him because he wants to play in the Premier League and show people what he can do, because he was, you know, prior to coming to the Premier League, he was Holland's World Cup keeper, a superstar, a world-class player. And this is a great opportunity for him to say, you know, I'm back.
Thankfully, his English is very good, because I don't think I could attempt Dutch. But no, he seems a good guy. Obviously, fits right in with us, training from day one. And again, you know, the same situation. You try to you know, extend your welcome and hope that every new lad sees what we're about. But he's experienced as well. He's been at you know, several clubs, so he's not new to coming into a new environment. But you hope that you know, he feels what we're all about.
So when Maarten joined, I had a text the night that he signed from Ross Wilson, just letting me know a little bio about Maarten, and said, you know, he's going to come in tomorrow morning. We'll show him around the training ground together, just have some options ready. So I knew that he had, you know, three kids, and I'd already made the calls to make sure they had places in school, the local schools. Also, sort of, he found out what sort of property he was looking for. You know, obviously how many people are going to live there and that sort of thing, in what areas. So he came in and we had a short list of 12 properties, and he went through them and chose the ones he wanted to visit. And you know, he and his wife went round and picked out the place that they think, you know, they can be happy.
I'm pleased because we've been able to approach things calmly, steadily, you know, in a very logical way. And it's always good to get players in early. So three signings early doors is good for us because they're ready and going straight into pre-season training. To get that balance between, you know, one of our young players coming through and signing young players with a similar profile to the kind of players we like, whether they come through or whether we bring them in, you know, that's been nice, and it's enabled Ronald to have a much more settled approach and fulfil the plan that he set out before the end of the season in terms of the dates for pre-season and the pre-season friendlies. It's just nice to have the squad with no turmoil coming into, you know, returning to training. So that's good.
Yeah, there was something that was right at the top of the radar, and I was aware of it. Les, it was one of the first things Les told me when I got here, and our conversations before I got here, that Callum was really, really important to the club, and this club's renowned for producing young players, and we want to be a club that has young English talent within our first team. The players that were spoken about there, you know, Dutch, Portuguese and Spanish, but English players are our priority, there's no doubt about that. And the progressing players from our academy is absolutely critical to our continued success. And I know it's something that, in my short time here, I know is close to the supporters' heart as well, that they like to see players progressing out of our academy, and they're proud of that. And everybody in the club's proud of that. And it was important for us to secure Callum's future. He's a fantastic young player, excellent young man as well. I met him for the first time the other night with his family, along with Matt Hale, who speaks immensely highly of him. And I know he was proud that night, Matt, and it's important for our academy that our most talented young players commit the future, and all credit to Les and Matt and the people that have worked with him for a long, long time, and convincing Callum that his future lies here.
So the important thing is that we're ahead of the game and we're not reacting. We've already got plans in place if such and such a thing, if a certain scenario happens. We had Nathaniel Klein all last season, virtually all game. We hadn't replaced Callum Chambers. And we were lucky that Kleine didn't get a long-term injury. We knew that Alderweireld could play there, which he did on a couple of occasions. We know that Yoshida can play there, which he did on a couple of occasions, but you don't want that long term. So we were always, always tracking and looking at young right backs in order to bolster the squad anyway. When it was clear that Nathaniel was not going to sign a new contract, we had to step that up in terms of, okay, if that happens, have we got someone who's ready to go in? And Soares had been on our radar for some time. As I said, he meets the profile. A decision then is, okay, is he ready? And we felt that he'd reached a stage in his career where, yes, he is ready.
The discussions with his former club, Sporting Lisbon, took much, much longer than the discussions did with Malaga. So it just took a long, long time, that one. That was probably ongoing for about a month. Once we agreed terms with the club and then with the agent, we had to wait quite a long time before we had Cédric here at Staplewood, because he was on international duty with Portugal. So we had to wait on that finishing as well, and then he came right after that. And he brought his whole family with him, actually, his mother and his brother and some others as well, to see the place. And as a family, they were really comfortable with Southampton as an option. He had a few well-publicised other options as well. So I think, again, meeting the people is obviously important to them as well, and seeing the facilities, seeing St Mary's, the stadium, and meeting a lot of our key people was important to him. And Ronald had a chat with him as well.
We never see a player that we haven't had two or three sets of eyes watching, and then we pull all that together. And Ross's job is to do that, and to be confident enough to say he's good enough for us. This is the right next step for him. And bring that to the table. As everybody knows, we're really proud of what we've achieved here. We've built this new training ground. It's impressive. That sends a message to the players that I'm actually joining a professional outfit if I come here. So that it's the personal contact, you know, usually initiated by Ross or Bill Green, followed by me, followed by Ronald. That personal contact makes a big difference. And then come and have a look at us. We're not afraid to show you anything. Come and have a look round. This will be where you sit and get changed. There's the pitch you're going to be working on. That message is that I'm joining, as both Cédric and Juanmi have said, I'm joining a big club.
So I'm going to the first training of Southampton, so I look forward and I'm excited.
And it's a new start. Are you a little bit nervous perhaps?
Yes, of course, a little bit. It's my first day, it's normal, but the football player have to be used to, so no problem.
Because for you it is different, isn't it? Because you've only really played, you had one loan spell, but you've only been with Sporting.
Yes, it's my second team that I play, so for sure I'm going to be okay, because there's everything here is nice, and everything in the club seems to be very good, so I'm okay.
And you saw the training ground when you came over to sign the contract, and you were impressed?
Yes, I was really impressed, because I didn't expect it. It's really nice and with a lot of condition, so that will be for sure very good for us, for the team. So I look forward to playing that ground too.
How do these facilities compare to Sporting's?
So Sporting have a good youth too, and for good condition. But that one is new, so seems to be better, and I'm fine with that.
Are you going to get Jose to take you out and show you everywhere?
Of course. Yeah, I'm sure he will. So it's very helpful for me to have Jose in the team, because he speaks my languages too, so it's easier for me to understand everything.
And of course, you'll see the manager for the first time as well.
Yes. I spoke with him before already on the phone, but as personal, it's the first time, so I look forward and I'm excited too.
Are you expecting a hard training session, or think it'll be okay today?
I think it's going to be okay. It's first train, it's normal. Yeah, coming from holiday, so for sure it's going to be like progressive, you know.
Are you looking forward to living in Southampton and living in this area?
Yeah, it's kind and it's calm. It's okay, Southampton. I don't know yet everything, but I'm already seeing nice places too. So I search a few houses too in internet. So in the next week I will see another one here, and then I have to decide where to stay.
How do you see the next month or two playing out?
It's interesting. It's not as hectic as it was last year, for obvious reasons. But I don't think the transfer window itself is as hectic. So I can see that building up. I guess Jim White's looking forward to transfer deadline day compared to last winter, because it does seem that people are keeping their counsel and things may happen late, and we want to make sure that we're actually not working on deadline day, that it's done and we're well prepared to kick off a Europa challenge as well as the season. So I think it's just going to be steady for us day to day. Don't panic, let's just get through the window doing the right things again and making sure we're ready for day one of the Premier League.
Say Shy City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now and then?
Yeah.
Do you think about me now and then? 'Cause I'm coming home again.
Home again. I met this girl when I was 3 years old, and what I love.